Don't point them at me.
Now this variety of squid I've never quite seen before.
Big snapper size bait. Small snapper size reel.
Uh-oh. It's about to get real.
So I've caught a snapper on this gear, and now we're going to try and catch a billfish on it.
So I'll look at it feeding right here. Look, right here, right here, right here.
We're game fishing. We're snapper fishing gear.
And I've got him on my snapper gear. Look at him go right there.
Sport fishing. To many, this means cruising around on a big white game fishing boat and catching and releasing game fish. Or fly fishing in a high country stream to catch a trout, only to release it again.
Oh, and away he goes.
While many call this sport, others call it playing with your food and believe that fish should only be caught to be killed and eaten.
Okay, tag them.
Yet sport fishing, be it fly fishing or big game fishing, generates billions of dollars in economic activity all around the world. And some of the countries that benefit the most were once impoverished island nations, where now, from a single fish, they can generate thousands of dollars, or even tens of thousands of dollars, from one fish that is then released to breed.
There we go, tagged and released. Yeah.
So while some might call this playing with your food, it is this industry that employs millions of people globally, which in itself puts food on the table.
She's out.
Other than fly fishing for trout, sport fishing isn't really promoted in New Zealand as an industry. But most saltwater anglers practice it in some form. For example, using lighter tackle, like soft bait, to get more enjoyment from catching a fish is sport fishing.
Hey, hey, that was a mean fight.
And choosing to release bigger breeding fish is also sport fishing.
He's going home.
And sport fishing can still go hand in hand with subsistence fishing, which is keeping just enough for a meal or two.
Yeah, dinner, bro. Kia ora tangaroa.
But at its heart, sport fishing is about enjoyment.
Here you go, boy.
Here, I'm snapper fishing to take home a feed. But I'm also sport fishing. I've dropped down to lighter gear to get a bigger thrill out of catching my dinner.
Big snapper-sized bait. Small snapper-sized reel.
So now, I'm going to take this same light tackle snapper fishing gear and I'm going to try and catch a billfish on it. Not as a stunt, but to help demonstrate how other places around the world are improving conservation as well as getting more value out of their fish through sport fishing. Much better than we do here in New Zealand. I'm going to start with billfish on my snapper fishing gear because of all of the fish that saltwater anglers aspire to catching, a billfish is right up there at the top of the list. And today, I'm off on an entirely new billfish journey for me. And this is the tackle I'm taking. Because the billfish I'm after is the sailfish. And while they're comparatively small alongside many of the other billfish, they're amongst the fastest and most acrobatic of all of the fish in the ocean. So I'm gonna see if I can catch them on my light snapper fishing gear. And if catching a snapper is a thrill on this gear, imagine what a sailfish will be like. And what's more, I get to do it in this incredible destination. Malaysia isn't one of the better known fishing destinations, but it's one of the gateways to the South China Sea, which is a large shallow body of water where the sailfish come to feed. And for decades, the locals have scoured these waters and become very good at catching them. Now let's remember, this body of water is surrounded by 2 billion people that love to eat fish. It remains calm and fishable year round. But they've chosen to get long-term value out of sport fishing over the short-term gains of bulk harvesting all of their fish. So today, they have a thriving fishery, which is why anglers, just like us, have come all the way here to spend our money. And for my traveling companion, Jason, he's never seen a billfish of any kind. So this place is gonna blow his mind. But on our first day of fishing, we've awakened to the rumble of thunder and there's rain like I have never experienced before. I mean, not ideal fishing, but it's so wicked to experience it. I've never seen anything like it, or felt anything like it. The whole place is rumbling. It's monsoon season, and we're greeted in Kuala Lumpur by this impressive electrical storm. But because these cells of weather are small, we still head out to sea, and it flattens off. So we get out our bait rods, because here, the locals say that fresh bait is essential to catch sailfish.
From what I gather, and there's a little bit of a language barrier going on here, that we're going to be live baiting today. So I would say you would best to just go to the bottom and jig our way up. Down to the bottom, there you go, we've got them on. You got them on, you're doing it.
Bro, hurry up, man, do something.
Just bring them up, swing them smoothly into the boat, because bait is ultra critical, I can't stress enough. Okay. How important that little guy is. Get him in the boat, in the boat, in the boat. Yeah, boy.
Yeah.
Okay. Our man's got a squid on.
Oh, yeah, here it is.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look at him shooting ink. Yes! Oh, I don't know whether we're going to use that as bait or whether we're going to eat it. I say eat it. Well, then again, what a beautiful bait. All right. Oh, I'm pumped. I'm getting pumped up about the bait fishing. This one here we eat?
Yeah, yeah, for you.
Oh, thank you, boss.
We've got some calamari to eat, and it doesn't take us long to catch a good supply of fresh bait for the sailfish to eat.
Aha, beautiful little baits.
So now we're heading for the sailfish grounds. Only I'm not sure where we're going to find sailfish out here in such a huge body of water. We're almost 60 nautical miles from port, and still, it's only 30 meters deep, and the water is green, not blue water that's normally associated with billfish. But as we approach a group of boats, I can see they're already hooked up, and as we get closer, we see sailfish feeding. They're jumping everywhere. I don't know if this is normal feeding behavior or if the storm has triggered a sailfish frenzy. But whatever it is one incredible welcome.
That was sick, bro.
What the? Mate, I don't know what's normal here, so I'm buzzing out at everything.
Oh, look, over here too. Look at him go.
Far. Yeah, there's some feeding over here, guys.
Is this every day?
Look, right there.
Whoa.
Well, right here, like right there.
Right here, there's one right here.
So I'll look at them feeding right
here. Right here.
Oh,
right
this here. Is ridiculous.
Right here.
So I'll look at them feeding right here, look. Right here. So that bait's gone right in front of them. Oh yeah, my bait's bit.
You're on.
So I'm just using bait runner mode. Okay, now that's enough jerking, he's going to jump.
Now he's going, he's on his way up. And I've got him on my snapper gear. Look at him whoa, go, whoa, right there. Whoa.
Oh yeah, boy. Oh. In no time at all, that fish has gone from the back of the boat to what? 150, 200 meters away. And that's because he's not encumbered by heavy drag.
Whee!
Yeah, this gear makes it so good.
He's coming out.
There he is. He's coming back towards the boat. He's gonna go again towards you. Oh, there he is. Oh, I can see the leader. The leader's right here, and he's gonna jump. No. Oh, there he is. Okay, we need to get a hold of him.
Look at that sail.
Okay, now that I've got a hold of a bill, I can get his mouth through the water. So by moving him forward, we're re-oxygenating them, because they don't breathe through their gills. Water passes through their mouth and out over their gills.
Right.
Just by towing them forward here, we're basically just sort of giving them sailfish CPR, if you like. This really is what sailfishing is all about. It's about preserving the fishery, because this fish could get caught many times over. It's gonna have thousands of babies that people will come here and pay to catch and release. I think it's a wonderful thing the sports fishing community around the world has adopted, catch and release. And, well, it's come as far as Malaysia, and you can see it's working.
Okay, buddy, where you go?
There he goes. Off from whence he came. That there is sport fishing, that's how it works. It's a beautiful thing. Even in a country that just thrive on eating fish can understand that some fish are more valuable alive than they are dead. We can learn a lot from that.
Bro, look at them.
Jason has already seen more billfish feeding on the surface than you would likely see in a lifetime fishing in New Zealand. And now it's his turn to catch one. I've got him on slightly heavier tackle, a Shimano Torium, like an entry-level kingfish set. But that's more than enough to overcome one of these sailfish. But unlike New Zealand, where it might take days, weeks, or even years to catch your first billfish, Jason waits only minutes.
Here you go, Jace. You bit. No, just wait for your instruction. Yep. Okay, click the lever up.
Jump, it's jumping out here. We've hooked him.
Wind the handle. You've got him. You need to get tight. You've hooked that fish. Wind. Okay. Go. Stop. There's line going out. Okay. You're going to jump again.
Oh, there he is out there. Look at him go. That's your fish.
Okay. Rod tip up, but we want to see a bit of. You know, that fish is the most important part in this whole sport fishing game. The only thing it doesn't know that it's a game. That fish is fighting for its life. Little does it know, all we're going to do is want to just get it up, take a photo, maybe tag it for research, let him go again.
This tackle has 50-pound braided line, which is heavy for these sailfish. Okay. But for Jason as a beginner, it means he can just enjoy it without having to concentrate too hard, because we've got a hook with a circle hook that hardly ever comes out, even when the line's slack. We've got good gear, strong line. There's really only one thing that could go wrong. And it does.
Oh no, the bloody line.
It's the dreaded bird's nest.
Oh gosh, what have you done?
The reel is completely tangled now, and there is no way any line can pull off the reel. So we'll just have to try and wind the line over the top of the tangle and see if we can hold on to this fish.
Whoa. We don't want to get down to that tangled zone. We're going to speed up a little bit, boss.
So, we're still letting him run though, bro?
No, we don't want him to run too far. Okay. Stop. No, we're winding in, going to stop him. We're going to have to tighten up, because once we get to that tangled line, it's going to crack off. We're going to lose everything. So we're going to have to go a bit heavier than we'd like to. Yeah, look, he's made his own game chair. He's made his own game fishing. Here we go, bro. Back around, bro, and I'll better grab that leader. Keep winding. There's your fish right there. Keep winding, bro, as I pull. If I let go, just get ready, because I might let go. He's got there.
Hey,
okay, watch out. He's coming, pointing towards us. They might end up on the boat. Go, here comes the leader.
Yeah.
Keep going. There it is, boy. There it is. A sailfish.
Yeah, boy.
Watch that bill, though. We don't want to whack you with the bill. Look at that. And that's what we've seen feeding everywhere here this morning.
Mate.
Sorry, buddy. You were caught by an amateur.
Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Whoa.
That's what it's been eating. Sardines. It's been feeding on sardines and it's just spewed them all up. Now that is something that all of the billfishes do. They can turn their stomach inside out. Anyway, we're going to get a quick photo of this guy and then we're going to let it go.
Okay.
You ready? Here we go. Hold on to him, mate.
Oh. Yeah, boy.
Oh, did you think?
Yeah, bro. Yeah. I can't give you five. Slap my face. Yeah, boy.
Look at that sail. And they use that big sail to herd up bait fish, and you can see he's very successful at it. We're not going to muck around, just roll on forward, we'll get a couple of picks. Are we all in?
Yeah,
we don't want to muck around, we're going to let him go. Shuffle around. We're just going to slide him nice and gently, head first into the water.
Okay. Later, bro.
Oh, and there he goes.
Oh, mean.
Like,
bro, bring it in.
Hey.
Oh, mean.
Right, another bait out, clickers on. Chances are we're going to get another bite. Looking at the number of, look, there's another one here. The number of sailfish that are around us. You see how he was using his sail there? When he was turning, he had his sail up, and they actually use that sail to herd the bait fish. So they herd them up and then kapow. And they are the fastest fish in the ocean over a burst. Well, you saw, like, we hooked up, he jumps there, and next thing you know, he's jumping there. It's like there's two of them. Yeah.
Oh, there's one just there. One just came up just before the balloon.
Yeah, you got him. If you want to up, turn that. There he is. Go. Now roll. Of course that was going to happen. Yeah, boy. Here you go, you got him. Well done, bro. You did that one yourself, mate.
You get dirty.
Let's see if we can make this one smooth.
Let him run a bit.
Yeah, let him run if he wants to run. I mean, look at this. We've got a real danger here. This guy here is hooked up of our fish tangling with another guy's fish. Look at this. It is insane.
insanity. Squid fishing.
Oh, look, they got two on.
Whoa.
Holy good gosh. Far out, there was close to jumping into their boat. Keep it tight, keep it tight.
Look at them feeding right here.
Look, I'm busy.
Whoa. You get that shot, bro? Look, there's a bait ball at the back of those guys' boat.
Whoa. Jason is hooked up. The boat next to us has two sailfish hooked up, and there's more of them feeding between us. This is incredible, but the risk now is that Jason's line could get cut off if it touches the line of the guys on the other boat. And that is exactly what happens.
Well, it's just about wrapped in around the back of those guys. Oh, look at that.
Gone. Right.
Look at them feeding right here.
Now, you won't see this often. When you're hooked up to a billfish, and the boat next to you is also hooked up, and their line cuts through your line.
Oh!
There was nothing we could do to stop that, but you still can't help but be disappointed. Not because we lost the fish, but now that fish has to drag around 100 metres of our braided line until it can either shake the hook or the hook corrodes out. And as sport fishers, we like to take care of any fish that we choose to release, because it's our responsibility. But really, there's nothing much we can do once that line is parted.
Damn it.
But overall, for our first day, that was an incredible introduction to sport fishing in Malaysia. And I've got a feeling there's better yet to come, because tomorrow we're fishing not just for sport, but for the table. And in a country that's world famous for its cuisine, that's got to be something to look forward to.
Free jumper. Looks like he's hooked.
Whoa. Has it got a fish on it?
Yeah, we've got a fish on it.
I've got a fish on the end of this. This could be the fish that you've lost, Jack.
Get ready for my call cut. Oh.
We are in Malaysia, fishing in the South China Sea for sailfish, the fastest and most acrobatic of the billfish. And after just one day on the water, I'm blown away by what I've seen. We're here to try and catch some sailfish on light tackle and see how the locals have established a thriving charter fishing industry by promoting catch and release. But while this is fantastic, I love eating fish too. So we start the day looking for some tasty treats for the table.
We're doing, well, what is a bit of a Malaysian tradition, jigging for squid. In a way that I've never seen before, they've got a sinker to get it down to the bottom, then on a little branch they've got their squid jig. And today we've got with us Sky and Rumley. You got the technique down, Jace?
Yeah, mate.
You want to cast out a little bit, maybe? So jig, 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 stop. Oh, soft baiting, really?
Yes. You got him.
Yeah,
hey, Rumley!
Yeah, don't point him at me.
Now, because it's not only us that loves squid, everything in the ocean wants to eat a squid. I mean, there's that delicate, succulent white flesh which is full of carbs and energy for the fish. And what's more, there's no bones. So everything's trying to eat the old squid. So they've got to have some defense. And one of the things they can do is, like a jet unit, they suck water inside their shell and they pump it out really fast, so they can squirt forward and they can squirt backwards as well. They're one of the few fish that can go in two directions. And you can see there, when they're under distress, they're really squirting, trying to get away. And also, they can fire a cloud of ink, which takes the oxygen out of the water, so the predators can't swim through it. And in the darkness of the ink, they can make their escape. They're an incredible little fish, the squid. Now, this variety of squid I've never quite seen before, but one thing in common with all squid is that you'll find them right throughout the oceans of the entire world. And they travel in great groups, and they'll always have food, because by the time they get through to 13 months old and they're ready to spawn, one third of the squid have eaten the other two thirds. They will eat each other, they'll cannibalize each other if there's not enough food. And they look cute and cuddly, but they are a voracious predator, right up to their big cousins, the Archaeotuchus or the colossal squid. Incredible. And incredibly tasty. There you go there, look. That's what I was talking about before. That squid there is trying to eat his mate that's hooked because he's vulnerable. I told you, mate, they're cannibals.
Yes!
This is so cool. I've never done daytime squid fishing before. And the rewards, oh well, delicious.
There's a party up the front.
All right. Oh, I'm pumped.
Well, look at this in here. A bin of squid on ice, and that's what? Not an hour's work. And well, that's the food sorted. And now, off to the sailfish grounds.
Yesterday, we fished just how the locals do it, which is basically drifting around with baits out. But today, I've brought with me some gear and techniques that I've picked up from fishing for sailfish in the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean. And it's my turn to repay the favour and show the locals a new method for catching sailfish.
Okay, so we've got the dredge, which is gonna act like a school of panicking bait fish. And then we're gonna tie it behind the boat. We've got the camera in the back to catch the action. We'll see if we can't try a new fishing technique here in Malaysia. Because we know the locals' technique works. Oh, I hope this does too. Okay, a little bit faster, a little bit faster. Okay, now the next part of the equation is a bait. Now what's gonna troll this little bait, which is one of our little bait fish we've been using. And that's just gonna sit behind the dredge. So the theory is, the sailfish sees the shimmering shoal of bait fish, comes up to investigate, and they always eat the straggler. This is gonna be this guy just hanging out the back there, wiggling along.
Towing dredges and teasers for billfish is the go-to method for captains all around the world, and it's particularly good for sailfish. So I've brought along the gear to show the locals just how good it works, and it doesn't take long for our first customer to arrive.
To your left, to your left.
Guy, to your left, just right there. On the teaser. Get ready then, get ready.
We've got sailfish that are coming in on the teaser, but they're not interested in eating my bait. Once they've had a look, they just peel away and continue feeding on bait fish.
Yeah, yeah, there's one right, two. Yeah, 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 go port, go this way and go around them. Yeah, yeah, now around. Yeah, there's around, three around, of them
around.
Right there.
Right here.
Look at that. Hook around. Keep circling around, they're feeding right there.
They're coming, man.
We're now trolling the dredge right in front of the sailfish feeding aggressively on the surface.
Oh, look at them feeding right here.
But now, they are showing absolutely no interest in the dredge, the teaser, or my bait.
Far out. Now I just think there was too many. You can see them feeding right next to us. We've just got a pitiful little shoal of bait fish compared to what the sailfish were feeding on right there. And they were just too focused on their own food to come across to our artificial lures.
They're right here. Right here, they've seen it. They're coming.
Oh, yeah, boy! Yeah! Oh, fell out of the water. Oh, how many of them are there? Oh, my goodness. It's hard to count them.
Look at them.
My rats. One, two, three, four, five.
Bro!
Oh, yeah, this is feeding out here.
Right in front of the boat.
Look at them. They are right next to the boat.
They're everywhere. Whoa, we've got a big bait ball down here.
Look at the bait ball, look at the bait ball.
They're attacking
the sailfish underneath it.
Oh, I can see them just all the way out there, bro.
Oh man, we've got to get in the water with that, bro. You hopping then?
Oh no, what
are you saying?
Mini sharks.
Some mini sharks?
Yeah, bull shark around 200 kgs.
Bull shark?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, no, they're not good ones.
They're not good news.
It's okay, so me and Kane will go together, we'll be safe.
Yeah. I can swim faster than
Yeah, that's right. And so Kane is bait. Kane is bait because cameramen get anywhere. only one of me, okay? Say all clear, neutral. No, very clear, so we know that the propellers aren't turning. If we are in the water and we do one fist like this in the air, that means we need to get out fast. We've got some sailfish feeding here on the surface. It'll just be amazing if we can get close to them. My main job though is to keep an eye on Kane's back because of the bull sharks and tiger sharks.
As soon as I hit the water, bam, there's a sailfish right there in front of me. And now the shark safety plan has gone straight out the window. I just want to get up close to these things and watch them feed.
They're all over the place.
The sailfish are coming in from all directions, and I don't know which way to look. And by the sounds of it, the guys on the boat have got a pretty good view too.
Oh yeah, look at that, man. They are everywhere. Everywhere you look. This, enjoy, yeah man, big time. This is pretty spectacular. There's about half a dozen or more sailfish out there. Kane and Matty are out there. So I've just got to keep my eyes out. Look, there's one right here. Just right there, guys. To your left. Just right there, right there.
They're coming to you.
There's one right up behind Kane. Oh, mate, they're everywhere.
The sailfish seem to be spread out over a large area. This is because the bait ball has broken up and scattered. But the sailfish's speed, agility, and eyesight allows them to pick off the tiny bait fish one by one. And although Kane and I are slow and cumbersome by comparison, the sheer number of sailfish means we got to see plenty of sailfish up close.
Party time, man.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah?
There was at least 10 there. At least 10. Right in our face. At least 10.
Oh man.
Just in front of you.
Just in front. Feeding. Whoa. They're feeding on little bait, that big.
Oh, right here. Right there. Like right there.
Uh-oh.
Let him run. There he is over there. Look, coming over here. We've got him hooked.
Uh-oh.
It's digging into the leg, bro.
Oof. Enjoy. Don't forget to enjoy. Sorry, I'm giving you all these instructions.
No, it's good.
I'm giving you all these instructions. One of the things I forgot to tell you is to enjoy it.
Chase is getting the hang of this now. He's had a bit of experience, so it's a bit easier for him to keep his composure, because when there's a billfish on your line and it leaps into the air, it's easy to get into a panic because you want it so badly.
Oh,
and at the heart of all sport fishing, it's about the enjoyment. That's what people pay for. The experience and the enjoyment of conquering a fishing challenge that you may never have dreamed of completing. And right now, Jace is very close to completing his first billfish capture all on his own.
Okay, Sky's gonna grab the leader for you.
But the catch isn't complete until we've got the fish under control and in hand.
Turn your rod. So keep your eyes on what this fish is doing. Let's go get him.
Let's go. I can see him
there's
down
the
there.
You can see that fish down there. It looks magnificent.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there's your fish, Jace. Yeah, boy.
Get in there, give him a hand.
Okay. Excuse me. Okay, so wait on the other side of the boat, Jace. Oh, you're going to bring him up. He's going to bring him up for you to have a look at. And look at that resplendent, just amazing sail. And they use it like a shield to herd up the bait fish. Slide him over head first. Slide him on in. We'll go get him. See if you can lift him up. Lift him up. Grab a hold.
Yep.
Good work.
Good stuff.
Okay, we're going to have to do some CPR on this guy. Whoa.
The sailfish has wriggled free and rolled upside down. And once upside down, they can take some time to get reorientated and swim upright again. So we need to get a hold of it and tow it forward to revive it so it can swim upright. Because the longer it stays like this, increases the likelihood of it falling prey to sharks.
Oh, jeez.
Now I'm just worried about a tiger shark that might be coming up after this guy. Okay, forward. Yep, forward. Let's start towing this guy, keep him alive. There you go, look at him, he's coming to life already.
Alright!
Okay, there he goes.
Yeah! Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Nice work, team. That's another
that's
one. There's no script here, man.
Yeah.
The thing is, it's our responsibility as sport fishers. It is a catch and release fishery, and every fish counts.
We're also promoting our sailfish.
That's right. You guys are smart. Very smart. Because more money comes in from
Tourism.
Yeah.
Then killing them to sell.
Anglers around the world has come here.
I better put a shirt on. I better put my shirt on.
So now you'll recognise this reel, the talica. Now I use the great big talicas for catching blue marlin and swordfish. This little guy here, the talica 8, is what I used to catch snapper on. I love them, they're so smooth. So really, everything's just gone miniature here. We're game fishing with snapper fishing gear, but this is quality gear designed for this sort of work. And I mean, you can't make the sailfish any bigger, but you can make the gear smaller and match it to them. And well, it's just as much of a thrill catching them on this gear as what it is catching a big blue marlin on big gear. And there's no shortage of action.
Whoa!
Yeah, look at that guy.
Whoa.
Oh yeah, I'm bit. I've got one on, get ready. It is hissing. Oh, there he is in front of us. Wow, look at him, he's a nice size one. Oh yeah, boy. That was mean. Monofilament line this time. We have been using braid for greater capacity, but you can't get past the smoothness of mono, and this is a low stretch mono. Super 21 Suffolk. Oh man, this is just mint gear to be doing this on, honestly. Now, while I've got a lot of line out like this, I don't want to run out of line. I'm actually backing down on the drag. Now that might seem unusual, but as that arbor, the reel gets smaller, the drag increases. It's like a gear. So just while it's accelerating fast, I back off on the drag. Now that it's not taking line so fast, I can afford to go up just a wee bit. Oh, look at that. I haven't got a lot of drag and I don't want to overdo it. Only 8 kg line. There's sailfish feeding right here in front of us, look. Gonna jump over the top. Oh no, I've got to lift my rod up over the top of these sailfish here. Otherwise there's sailfish feeding right here in front of us, look. And I've got to get my line up and over the top of them. And look at them right here. Look at that, bro. So if handling this big sailfish on my snapper fishing tackle isn't already tricky enough, I've now got to steer my light line around these sailfish feeding next to us.
Sailfish feeding right here in front of us, look.
Already today, we've had a hooked sailfish cut off from the boat hooked up next to us. And now, if these feeding sailfish so much as bump into my line, it's all over.
Far out, that was close. My line almost rubbed on the bill of that sailfish there, the one that was feeding.
Hey,
that's a better one, eh? Trust us to hook the biggest one on the lightest line.
All right, I can't believe this line hasn't snapped.
You weren't expecting to get one this big?
One that stays up on the surface that's this big is no problem, because we can maneuver the boat and chase him. Because
right,
he's staying down deep. Far out. Got a big stingray on there. Man, I was not expecting a fight like this. Now, I love surprises.
So to get this fish up is going to require some patience, but not too much patience. Because we want to release this fish, the sooner we can get it, the better. So right now, I'm pushing this line to its limit.
Yeah, I rolled him in, I think. Yep.
Yep,
there we go, see? Roll him over, just push that line to the brink. Yeah, oh yeah.
Hey, mate.
Still got some go, that's incredible. After this amount of time. Yeah. It's right there. Just drive the boat up on him. Don't let it slip through your hands. Hold him. This one's wild still. It's a much bigger fish. Gone, he's away. Look at him boost away. Look how much strength he still had after all of that. Oh man, how was that?
Mate, what's up with this?
Oh, you just wait and see.
I've been blown away by the number of sailfish here in Malaysia and how well the locals have done in making a thriving industry out of catch and release.
Gone, he's away.
We've caught so many sailfish that I'm running out of challenges. And then I remember the bait rod I brought along. I've got an idea.
I'm just using this bottom reel here, which I brought along to catch bait fish on. It's exactly the same set as my son uses. He fishes off the wharf with it.
Now I'm using kids' fishing tackle that's worth around $100. It's low-cost gear, but the perfect way to demonstrate that catching a billfish really is within the means of everyone.
Okay, cast this bait.
right out to him if I can.
He's coming straight at it. Look at him, he's coming straight at my bait. Oh, he's taking my bait now. Yeah, just grabbed it.
Okay, it looks like I'm hooking up on the bait rod. Okay, cast this bait right out to him if I can.
He's coming straight at it. Look at him, he's coming straight at my bait. Oh, he's taking my bait now. Yeah, just grabbed it.
Okay, it looks like I'm hooking up on the bait rod. Okay, we've got him on the bait rod. Oh, here he comes. There we go. We got him. Far out. This place is just blowing my mind and it's not getting old. Just like that. We just sat down and had some lunch, feeding all around us. Okay, lunch is over, guys. Cast in with my bait rod. With my bait rod, I've got another sailfish on. Look at this noodle of a rod. Oh, yeah. Look at this reel go. He's going to jump again. How good. On a bait rod. See, now there's no excuses for not getting into game fishing. We've seen you don't need to be an expert. You don't even need expensive gear. There he is.
Using light gear like this not only ups the challenge and the thrill, but it also increases the visual aspect.
Oh, here he goes, he's going to jump again. I'm just reading this rod. It is a 10-pound rod.
Can handle the jandle.
Don't want to tire him out too much. We want to make sure we can release him in good condition.
He might come up here.
Right up there. Right there. He's coming up again. Let's go get him. Okay, you're going to have to get the gloves on, bro. Okay, here's the leader, Jess. Okay, we're going to bring him around the side. We're going to bring him around the side. Ease him up, ease him up. There you go, you're doing it. You're bringing him in good. Good job, bro. Nice work. I'm just going to come and help you out. That's it. You want to keep his head in the water. Look at that, another awesome sailfish caught on a bait rod. Oh, there he goes. He's just trucking away beautifully. Woo! And there it is on my son's sprat fishing rod.
We have achieved more than I'd hoped for here in Malaysia. So we just sit back for a minute and decide how we're going to use our last few hours here. And then a sailfish just starts jumping.
Look, right there, right there.
And
right
jumping.
There.
And jumping.
Whoa.
Woohoo!
Free jumper. Looks like he's hooked.
Try to rescue him. Whoa. He's on the side though.
Tracking him. He's coming at us now.
Uh oh.
Whoa. How many times are you going to jump?
This sailfish has jumped right past us and is behaving like it's hooked. Only there's no boats around us. And I think back to Jason's fish that got cut off. Could it be the same fish? I don't know, but it could be trailing line that it's trying to get rid of. So Kane jumps into the water and sure enough, he sees some fishing line.
Has it got a fish on it?
It's getting heavy now, yeah.
Yeah, we've got a fish on it. Okay, someone snapped off on a fish. Here, pass me the other glove. Pass me my other glove. Jump in the boat. Just handlining him on braid and even cut through my glove. I've got a fish on the end of this. Okay, just be careful of that braid, because if it runs and gets wrapped around anybody, it's just going to cut through them.
This is the same braid fishing line that Jason was using. Could it be the same fish that was cut off? Or another fish that someone else has broken off? I just don't know. It's so crazy. But right now, we just need to figure out how to get this fish in.
This is too freaky, it's freaking me out. We saw a sailfish jumping and jumping and jumping, and we're like, that is not free jumping, that's like a hooked fish. I don't know if this makes any sense, it's just buzzing me out. Okay, wait, I've run my toe. And it appeared as though it had a hook in its mouth. So we look in the water and we see a bit of braid. And now I'm handlining a sailfish on a piece of braid. This is incredible. Oh, it's going on a run now. And if this gets around anyone, we've got to cut it. Oh, I've got a big knot on the braid. Uh-oh. I'm going to have to let it go. Got knots now. Get ready if I call cut. Oh. Yeah, I know. Don't get caught in that, bro. Back up faster. Back up. Oh, he's jumping up behind us. Behind you. Behind you.
There he is.
Again. Far out. Grab that rod down. Grab that rod down.
This one.
What are your knots like?
Granny knots.
Nah,
no one can tie knots, eh? Backwards.
Oh. Someone else is going to have to take the gloves and hold it while I tie the knot. Round this way, bro.
Just need for you to hold that real carefully. Don't wrap it around your hands. Go, I'll take my gloves off to tie this knot. Just keep hand lining it in.
Back up.
If you ever let that knot go out, let it go out. Don't get it back.
Oh, shit.
Hold it there.
Yep.
Okay, that'll do. Yep, let go. Yep. Okay, we got him on the rod now. Chuck those other gloves on, Jace. My gloves.
Now the line's on the reel, the danger is averted, and it's just a simple case of winding the fish into the boat.
He's right here.
Slowly, ease him up. Once you get him close, get a hold of that belt. Yep, there you go.
Shot, bro.
Oh, there he goes. He's just trucking away beautifully. And that is one sailfish that would not have survived had we not spotted him. Now his hook's out, swimming away. Beautiful.
Right there, bro.
Oh, yeah, boy.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.